So we will discuss about the counting sort today, and the counting sort, as the name suggests, will be counting something, and it's a linear sorting technique. It means it will be able to sort the given elements in the linear time. So let us take an example and understand how does the counting sort work. Let's say we have the elements 7, 4, 3, 2, 1, 7, 1, 3, 2, 4, again 3. These are the indexes of the elements in the given array. So we have a total of 13 elements, and you can see that the number of elements are 13, and there are some of the elements which are getting repeated. So as 1 is appearing twice, 2 is appearing twice, 3 is appearing 3 times. So we have the flexibility here that the elements can be repeated any number of times. But it's a proven fact here that the counting sort will be able to work on only the elements in which the largest element is much less than the total number of elements. It means it will be able to sort the elements which are of a very short range. Here you can see that the numbers are ranging from 1 to 7 only, okay, and the number of elements are 13. It may so happen that we have let's say 1 lakh elements, but the range of the number is only from 0 to 9. So we are going to deal with a very small range numbers in the counting sort. You can treat it as a limitation of counting sort also. Okay. Now if I say that k is the largest number of the set and n is the total number of the elements, then this k is going to be much less than n. Fine. So as the name suggests that we have to count something. So let's take a counting array C and define the size of this counting array as the largest n. It means since I have only the numbers up to 7, so the size of this counting array is going to be 7. Let us initialize all the elements of this counting array as 0. What does it mean? We are considering that 1 appears 0 times, 2 appears 0 times, 3 appears 0 times, and so on and so forth. 7 also appears 0 times. This is our assumption initially. Now after this we will count the number of elements, means how many times a number appears in the original array. Let's say this is 7. So we will go at the 7th position in counting array and will update its counting by 1. Now for the next element 4, go to this 4th index in C array and update the counting by 1. 3, go to the 3rd position in C array, increment it by 1. Go to the 2nd position in C array and increment it by 1. Go to the 1st position, increment it by 1. Go to the 7th position and increment it to 1. Increment it by 1, it will now become 2. Go to the 1st position, it now becomes 2. Go to the 3rd position, it now becomes 2. Go to the 2nd position, it now becomes 2. Go to the 4th position, it now becomes 2. Go to the 3rd position, and now it becomes 3. So we can see here that one appears 2 times in the original array, 2 appears 2 times in the original array, 3 appears 3 times in the original array, 4 appears 2 times in the original array, 5 is not there in the original array, 6 is not there in the original array, and 7 appears twice in the original array. So we have done with the counting of the elements. Now let us do some more work with the C array, counting array, and try to find out how many elements are less than or equal to a particular element. Now the number of elements which are equal to 1 is 2, and there is no element which is less than 1 in the array, in the original array. So total number of elements which is less than or equal to 1 is 2. Now if I try to find out how many elements are less than or equal to 2, for this let us find out first how many elements are less than 2. So less than 2 is only 1, and the number of elements which are less than 2 is 2. So number of elements which is less than or equal to 2 will be 2 plus this 2, which is 4. Similarly, the number of elements which are less than 3 is 4. What are the elements which are less than 3? They are 1 and 2. Counting of 1 is 2, counting of 2 is 2. So a total of 4 elements are less than 3. And how many elements are less than or equal to 3? 4 plus 3, 7. Similarly, 7 plus 2, 9 elements are less than or equal to 4. 9 plus 0, 9 elements are less than or equal to 5. 9 plus 0, 9 elements are less than or equal to 6. 9 plus 2, 11 elements are less than or equal to 7. Fine. Seems to be some error. Now, let us take a B array, which is the final array in which I will store the answers. Size of B array will be same as the size of the original array. Means if original array contains 11 elements, so the final array will also contain the 11 elements. Now, we will process the original array from backside. Okay, I'll pick this element first, the last element, which is 3, and then I'll go to the third position in C array, which is telling us 7. So go to the 7th position in the final array, let's say B is the final array, and at 7th position in the final array, store this 3. Okay, what we did? We have taken the last element from the original array. We have gone to the 3rd position in counting array, which is telling us 7. Go to the 7th position in the final array and store this 3. Along with this, do one thing more. Decrement this by 1. Okay, earlier it was 7, now we have made it 6. Why we have done this? Next time when we will have a 3 coming, I will store that 3 at 6th position. Now let's take this element now. We are processing it at the backward approach. So take this element 4, go to the 4th position in counting array, and then 9, go to the 9th position and store 4 here. This 4 is stored at the 9th position. Fine. And now this is decremented by 1. Every time we store an element in the final array, C array count is decremented by 1. Now go to this element, 2nd element, which is 4. Go to the 4th position, store 2 here, and decrement it by 1. Go to the 3rd position in C array, which is telling us 6. So at 6, store 3 and decrement it by 1. Let us make it 5. Now go to the 1st position. This is telling us 1. At the 1st position, store 1. Fine. Okay, this was decremented by 1. So this is actually 2. So this will be stored at, this 1 will be stored at 2nd position, and after this we will decrement it by 1 to 1. Go to this element 7, go to the 7th position, which is 11th position, store 7 here. Decrement it by 1. Go to the 1st position in the C array, which is telling at 1. So store 1 here. Decrement it by 1 to 0. Go to the 2nd position, which is telling us 3. Store 2 here. Decrement it by 1. Go to the 3rd position, it is telling us 5. So at the 5th position, store 3. make it 4. Go to the 4th position, which is telling us 8. At the 8th position is store 4 and decrement it by 1 to 7. Go to the 7th position, which is telling us 10, and store 7 here. Decrement it by 1 to this 9. Now you can see that we have the numbers in the ascending sequence. And now what, if you observe one thing, that this 3 is this 3. This 3 is this 3. And this 3 is this 3. Similarly, if you see, this 7 is this 7. And this 7 is this 7. It means, whatever was the order of the same element in the original array, we are achieving the same in the final array. It means the relative ordering of the same number in the original array and in the final array are same. Because of this only, we can say that this technique is a stable sort technique. So counting sort is a stable sort. Now let us try to write the algorithm for the same. We'll write the algorithm the same way what we have done in the procedure. So this is the algorithm for counting sort, wherein I have been given an array of numbers. It has n elements, and let's say k is the largest element. Fine. So what we are going to do, we are first going to take a counting array C, and first we will initialize all the elements of this counting array to 0. So for I equals to 1, 2, k, the size of the counting array is going to be equal to the largest element, and every element of this C array is initialized to 0. After this, we will count every element of the original array, and we will store the count in the C array. So the total number of elements in the original array are n. So for I equals to 1 to n 2, we will take every element of original array. We will go in the C array, and we will update the count. If earlier at AI position in the C array was 0, we will update it to 1. So by this we can find out the total number of elements, total number of 1s, total number of 2s, and so on and so forth. Fine. Now after this I will find out how many elements are less than or equal to a particular element. You see what we have done here. This is the count, and after this what we have done, we have set first element at as 2. The second element was the addition of first and second element. Third element was equal to the addition of second and the third element. So for I equals to 2 to k do, C of I is equals to C of I plus C of I minus 1. So C2 is equals to C2 plus C1. C3 is equals to C3 plus C2. By this way, we will be able to find out how many elements are less than or equal to a particular element. After this, we will post the element in the B array, that is the answer array for us. Size of the answer array is same as that of the original array. And we are going to process this original array in the backward approach. Why we have applied the backward approach? Because we need to have a stable sort. This could have been done by going forward also. We would have got the elements in the ascending sequence, but the stability could not have been managed. So just to maintain the stability, we are going to process it in the backward approach. So for let's say I equals to n 2 1 step minus 1, what are you going to do? We're going to refer to the AI element. This will tell us an index in the C array. And whatever is the index of C array, that will be treated as the, whatever is the element in C array, that is will be treated as the index of B array. And at this position, I will store the element AI. If you see, 3 is AI. We will go to this third position in the C array. Okay, so C of AI, which is telling us 7. and then we'll go to the seventh position in the B array. So this entire part is treated as the index of B array. We'll go to the seventh position and we'll store the element AI, that is 3. Right? Now after this, we will decrement the count of C array by 1 such that the new element comes at one less position than the current element. Fine. And finally, we can return the C array, or you can store the answer in A array by transferring every element to the A array one by one. Now, if we analyze this algorithm, this loop requires k effort because this runs up to k times. This loop requires n effort because it runs to the n times. And then this loop runs for k minus 1 times. And this loop runs for n times. N to 1 n times. So what is the total effort required? K plus n plus k minus 1 plus n. This makes out 2n plus 2k minus 1. And we've already seen that k is much, much less than n. Okay? So with respect to n, k is negligible. So we can say that the complexity of the counting sort is n. What notation we should use? There is no step that we can skip here. Every step has to be performed. So there is no option of skipping any step. And only this much effort is required. So the complexity of counting sort is theta n. This is the time complexity. Best case or worst case, there is only one case. And you will have to perform the entire effort. No, none of these steps could be skipped. What is the space complexity? What are the elements we took from our side? A is given, N is given, and K is given. The extra variables that we have took from our side is IE and this B array. So this IE and B array has a size N, and IE will be treated as one single variable. So N plus 1 is the total space required additionally for performing the counting sort. And the space complexity of this algorithm is going to be theta n. I'm writing it theta n because there is no way to improve this. Fine. Only theta n, only means B array is compulsorily required. So B array is compulsorily required. So n space will be required. And 1 is for this I variable. So there is no way we can skip it out.